Welcome back everyone. In this new live development video about building an auto battle game, in this video we're going to improve our in-game HUD a bit so that it can more properly reflect what's going on in the game. So first thing we're going to do is add a pop-up text when we're switching phases. So let's do this. So it might look kind of cosmetic to you, but it's actually not, because we do need, so it's going to size to its content. We do need to see what's going on in the game, and what's a better way for that than to have something popping off the screen to tell us nothing. So that's why. So it's gonna read combat phase and etc. So we're gonna head, so we want an horizontal box, we want to put this, vertical. We want a vertical box, we don't want that, we want that in here. We want an image down the vertical box, we want the vertical box in the middle of the screen. We want that to be sized to its content, and we want the image to be 1 pixel, maybe 2 pixel large. We want this to be like 80. And if we hit play, okay, that's fine. It's fine. VBox phase phase feedback, we're gonna call this. Text current phase, not current phase. Phase pop-up text, phase feedback text. Text phase feedback is enough. Image, this is just a line break. We don't care about this. We don't want to make this a variable, we don't care. But the text, yes, we want this to be a variable, and we want the VBox to be a variable. The VBox is going to be hidden by default, like this. And we want to create an animation which says pop phase feedback, and this is going to get vertical box, it's going to move it on the left. It's gonna last like 1.5. the initial transform is going to be here, we're gonna say -200. We don't care. In here it's gonna be there, so if we hit play, so it's kinda too slow. It's kinda too slow, so we'll try this. Okay, we'll be fine with this. We'll add some kind of scale dynamism here, just for the sake of enjoying some kind of game feel. So if we head over there, it's not pleasing at all. It's not pleasing at all, because it's a bit too fast. Maybe we're gonna move this here. No, it's too slow. Yeah, we want that. Yeah, we want that here. Maybe I'm too shy on the values. Oh, we're just gonna remove that frame. Okay, we don't care. In here, then it's gonna wait like this. Then it's gonna fade up over here, over there, like this. So yeah, there, so our curve, yeah, we don't want the curve, we don't want this to be curved at all. sorry, I snoozed. So yeah, we don't want this to be curved. Let's head over there. I don't even know why it curved it. So I think we're just gonna remove what we've done on the curve. We're gonna remove this, we're gonna head over there. And nope, we want zero all the way from here to there. We want zero, we don't care. I don't know why it added frames here. We don't want any frames there, so we'll just quickly re-add these like this. 200 minus 200 minus 2000, I meant. So it's ugly as hell, but we don't care for now. We may be tweaking this afterwards, we'll see. I will be tweaking this for sure outside offline. So yeah, fine, it's going to fade a bit before it's going to fade here. And in there is going to be at 1 opacity. Okay, we're fine with this. So we're going to have a new function, pop phase feedback. Display phase feedback. We couldn't name it this way because we already have something called the same way. I think it's the animation, yeah. So we want to play this whenever this is being sent. And this is going to be sent to utilities, bind to game state initialization, and on enter new phase it's going to be events. Get player state ref utilities, on player match ended events, display phase feedback, it's going to be feedback. So when we enter a new phase, we're going to display phase feedback. We don't care. Oh yeah, we can. Maybe we can. We're gonna. We don't care about this because we have a reference to the game state, so we can check for the phase here. Get current phase. To string, we want the enum to string. And we want text phase. Is that it? Phase feedback, set text. We should have built another widget which does this, but it doesn't really matter right now. And we're also gonna say that in here it's visibility, sets it to hidden when it's completed, and in here it sets it to self it test invisible. So it didn't read anything. VBox face feedback set tooltip text, not at all. Text face feedback set text like this. Recruit phase. So it sends the information that we actually started the game. So this is why it was useful to create that. Right away we are seeing something wrong here. A new phase started. We're setting set phase with none as value somewhere. Maybe because the phase timer ends. And the current phase is none, so it's bringing us to none. So I guess we're receiving that event in the beginning of the game, whereas we shouldn't. Not even, we're not even receiving that event. So that's not the issue here. So I'm not sure. This is the only place where, when are we really receiving this? We're receiving this twice. But we're only receiving this once, which is correct. So this is not a bug from here. I guess that's because when we're binding ourselves to the game state, we're not going to call this here. We're in the recruit phase. Now we're in the combat phase, back to the recruit phase, back to the combat phase. Back to the recruit phase, and indeed unproc here, but it doesn't matter, we're gonna fix all these issues at once in the next video. So what else do we want to do? We want to be sending an event when... So when we're binding ourselves to the game state, we're binding ourselves to on player match ended, and we're gonna need something that tells us what's going on in the matches. A bit like a kill feed. In game we're gonna create a new match feed. We're gonna need we're never gonna find this name. Match history, we're gonna call that, or rather just match, and we're gonna have a new widget, which is WGT match results, or end match entry, and we're gonna have a new widget called WGT match feed and match displayer. This is gonna be, so we're gonna open that up, add a size box, make that of the desired size, make the size box the size we want, like 40 by 40. This is gonna be a widget we have in the end, in the final game. So we're gonna add this somewhere. And match displayer. Where can we put this? We're gonna put this at the bottom right, I guess, for now. Yeah, for now we're gonna put this at the bottom right. Like this is gonna be sized to its contents, and in there we're gonna add a vertical box, an overlay, not at all, just a vertical box, VBox match and match results, and match container, VBox and match, that's it, that's a VBox, so that's already a container. We want to make that a variable, and in here we want to have a new function called create and match result, which is gonna have three entry, a result and a match result, and two players, in player up against results. We're gonna have this. And what do we want to do here? We want to create a widget. Whenever we receive this, the widget is going to be an end match entry, and we want to open that up. And this is also going to take three parameters, two strings and one end match result. In player up against results, and all of these are going to be public and exposed on spawn like this. We're gonna hit compile and go back there, hit compile, refresh all nodes like this. We're gonna grab our owning player and we're going to add this to our vertical box like that. So when we receive a match result, we are adding this. Yeah, so we only need to create this now. So this is just going to be an horizontal box composed of three texts. The horizontal box is going to be of the desired size. We're going to put this in a size box actually. The size box is going to be like, how much did we put this? 400, we're going to put this at 400 as well. And like 40. All these texts are going to, the horizontal box is going to fill, and these are going to fill as well. And they're going to be way smaller. Lights. And we want this to be like in the middle each time. Yeah, we want them to feel like this. Draw. This is versus. Oh, we're just gonna set draw for now. We'll see what it says if we do it like this. For now, it's fine. We're going to add an animation, pop animation. Or rather spawn animation. Or are we doing this? Yeah, we are. So this, we're going to add a track render opacity. It's going to like to last for like 3 seconds, and we're gonna have opacity for all this time, and then it's going to fade. So if we hit play, it's going to fade. And when this is spawning, it's going to play the animation and wait for the duration of the animation and destroy itself. Like this. And I think we need to grab this, make these variables text. In player text up against text results. All of these are going to be variables, and we're going to grab them here and set their text. Like this. To string, we want the enum to string. Like this. All we need to do now is the in-game HUD is gonna tell this when it receives a match ended. It's actually going to grab it and match this player. And how did we call the function? Create and match results. Like this. This should be called display and match results. We like this. So when we hit play, we have nothing, we're in the recruit phase, now we're going this way. Draw. So we drew, we made a draw, so we just want to, I think we're going to crop a part of the name like we've done for the fight zone debugger. I think it was in the entry. Yep, that this way. And we're going to make this a utility function. Crop player nickname, and we're gonna pass this here. It's gonna take a string and return a string, and it's gonna be pure. In nickname, return value, it's gonna grab this and put this here. Crop player nickname, we want to plug this here, we don't need that. We want to compile, go back to our end match, and we want to crop player name here. And we're gonna draw against this name this time around. We're in the combat phase. Draw. We want to make them last way longer. Yeah, for now we just want them to last for like 9 seconds, we don't care. Yeah, so this is being called, so we want to be collapsing this to a function. Update match entry like this, and we'll just quickly add two names to random name here. Oh, we are cropping its nickname here. So we don't want to be doing this here. Random name, random enemy, and match this player. We want to be cropping the name, the names here. Draw. So we're in the recruit phase, we went for a draw and it's disappearing, it's fine. So this is fine. We just want to add some kind of shadows to our text here, because it really shocked me actually that these and these are different shadows. So now they have the same shadow and we are happy about this. Yep. Last thing we want to do is to add a counter below the recruit phase, below the phase here, to indicate how much time it remaining before next phase starts. So we're going to add, we're just going to duplicate that text and put this here. Text phase counter. And we're going to offset that a bit, -0.5 like this. And the phase counter, we want that below the other text, and this is going to indicate 0, 0 by default. So So yeah, that's fine. On enter new phase. We're changing the text over there. But you we should be grabbing. Okay, I know how we should be doing this. In the in-game mod, in the in-game state, we're going to create a new variable called so current phase counter, which is going to be a float, and it's going to be replicated rep notify initial only. Current phase counter. Or is it going to be initial only? Yes, it is. Yes, it is. So we are at none by default. Yeah, that's it. So it's going to be rep notify initial only. We're fine with this. And I'm wondering how we're going to update this. Whoops. I didn't want to do this. So we want the in-game HUD. For now, we're just going to go for we're gonna bind this text, we're gonna grab the game state ref, we're gonna check if it's valid. If it's not, we're just gonna return 0000 like this, and if it's valid, we're going to grab counter. And I think there's something to put this into our from seconds returns the time span that represents the specified number of seconds. And I think that's what we want to do here. Minutes, 2 points, seconds. Oh, we're not gonna have zero with this. Time seconds to string, we'll try this. So yeah, we're never starting the countdown, but we will soon be, because will actually be face timer in here. Yes, so for now we should be modifying this, but I know we're gonna rework some of the logic here in the next video, so I don't really want to get myself involved in this too much. But we kind of want to see this, so we'll just do something real quick. Decrease countdown, decrease phase timer. We're gonna grab this and say decrement float. On phase timer, and we already had this, so we're gonna set this, and when this is equal to zero, if this is equal to zero, we're gonna call on phase timer, and or else we're gonna set timer by events, which is gonna start himself back. Decrease phase timer. We can't be looking at searching inside this, so after 1 second we're going to restart this. So decrease launch phase timer, we're gonna set this, and we're gonna set timer by events, which is going to be the event we just created. Decrease phase timer, time after 1 second. We're going to remove this and put this here. So when we launch the phase timer, we're saying 30 seconds for example, and 1 second after that, this calls that event, which reduced this to 29 for instance. And if it's equal to 29, we're starting again, and if it's equal to zero, we are finishing the current phase. So yeah, we said it was 5 minutes long, the phase, so we want to change that real quick. If we look at our class default, 20 and 20 for example, or like 10 and 10, I just want to see how it behaves. So yeah, phase timer. So we can see how unsync it is already. So we're in the combat phase for like 5 seconds. Oh, and it makes me think we have to handle the win of a player which is not facing any units. We're just gonna write it down while I think about it. Handle the fact that you can play against no units, you should auto win. So we just have to add some kind of check. So this is working. So we have a bunch of new feedbacks. So we have the recruit phase popping. We have the timer here. So we're gonna fight. And we're gonna win. Victory and defeat, that's fine. And why are we back into the combat phase already? It was kind of strange, wasn't it? I have the feeling it was kind of strange. But I'm not sure why. So we're in the combat phase. Units are fighting. Okay, so I know what's going on here. I guess that's here. We need to be doing something real quick. We need to be storing this into a timer as well. This is the phase timer. And I think what's going on, is that this should also be that. Well, actually, we'll just call on FaceTimer hand and ear for the time being, and we'll see how we handle that in the future. But for now, we just want to have a clean behavior. So we're back in the recruit phase now. Our units aren't fighting anymore. Oddly enough. And if we're starting using plus, units are fighting, so there is definitely something wrong. So we'll have to fix this. And now that guy is unsync. So yeah. So I know what's wrong, and we'll be fixing stuff one after the other. We're just gonna add this to our list of bug. But we have lots of feedback to understand what's going on in our game. And I think it's going to wrap up that video. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and hope to see you in the next one. Bye bye.